Finally, I've got the terminal online. Oh, who's that I see there? Hello? If you can hear me, press the terminal scan button. It's the green one. Oh, many thanks. You may have noticed that we've been suffering from a few system failures. As you can see, we've stopped dead in the middle of this asteroid belt. The last thing I detected was a large object colliding with the outer hull. The impact has caused some very important systems to go offline. Our computers are fried, and the doors are all locked, but the most pressing issue is that life support has failed. Being as I am rather fond of breathing, I was hoping to use the deck walkers to reactivate the life support. There's a walker on deck 6. If you can get it down to engineering, perhaps you can bring life support back online. The walker is coming online now. Are you getting the feed? There should be an A-B switch somewhere on that terminal. Flip it to the B position, and the walker should wake up. Now, the only way we can move between decks is by the cargo lifts. There's one near here. I'll light it up for you. Ah, this could be a problem. The floor plates are out of alignment. The pressure plate here seems to control some of the underfloor pistons. Look here, a ballast container. Try using... Good job back there, but I'm afraid the journey for breathable air has just begun. There should be another cargo lift on the other side of this room. This could be a problem. Oh, wait! I can see something. Ah, you're going to love this. Connect to that, for the port, and you now have access to a second walker. Flip the dial to access it. Ah, now this is an energy beam. Don't be afraid of them. The walkers were designed to interface with many of the ship's systems, these included. By standing over the beam, you can redirect the energy through the walker's eye lenses. These beams are used to power some ship systems, but they're powerful enough to destroy others. Walkers can accept the beam energy either through the underside port or directly into the head assembly. Yes, that's done something. See if you can bring the other walker through. I'm sorry to have to tell you this, but there is a serious plasma leak on this floor. It must have something to do with whatever is toying with the environmental systems. The plasma flow is confined below the deck. Just don't fall off any of the floor plates. Well, it certainly looks like someone has access to the deck configuration system for this floor. So someone with a fondness for pressing buttons. See if you can find a way through this mess to the cargo lift.
Thank you.
machines in here, somewhere, which both manage life support functions. Looks like they're both offline. Applying power from an energy beam would start one up, but to keep them running on their own, they both need to be powered simultaneously. Best of luck. My respiratory system thanks you in advance. This is one of the reflection crystals Team 4 were working on. More top secret stuff. You're getting quite the tour today. Reflection crystals are designed to split energy beams. This could be exactly what you need. Here's one of the machines. Remember, you need to power both simultaneously. Okay, here is one of the machines. Needs power. The inlet is the center of that activator ring. An energy beam. Good. Would have been in trouble without one of those down here. You've got them running! You can disconnect the beams now. They should run on their own from here. And that means we get to keep on breathing. It's a start. But with main power offline, we're not going anywhere soon. Always more to do, eh? Anyway, walk those robots over to the cargo lift, and we can investigate further. How does that sound? I'll turn my attention back to the internal scanners and see what I can see. Something is still very wrong on this ship.